to another edition of Vinnie's Kitchen. It's football Sunday, so we are going to cook some food that relates to football.
Chicken wings, chili. It's going to be awesome.
So anyway, what are you laughing at over there? This is what happens when we are watching football Sundays at the Amico's. Anyway, we're going to cook some chicken wings. I personally think that I have the best chicken wing recipe there is. It's a really simple recipe, but it tastes really good. So we're going to do that. We're also going to do some chili, which with me and Uncle Matt. Uncle Matt, this is my brother, Matt.
Thanks for having me.
Without him, there's no me. So anyhow, we're going to cook some chili together, kind of wing it, make it up as we go along, as everything we do. So let's get started. Chicken wings.
You gonna chicken wing it?
We're gonna chicken wing it. That's good. Here we go. They go in the fryer. An olive oil, Crisco. You can't put too many in at a time. I usually do 6, 8 maybe. That's 5, 7. We're gonna do 8. See how they are in there. We're good. I recently did another one of these when I was in Buffalo. I don't know if anybody's seen it yet, but I challenged a guy, a good friend of mine, Jimmy Butera. He has a restaurant in Hamburg, New York called Butera's. And we did a little wing challenge in his restaurant in Hamburg, and I Bobby Flayed his ass. So anyway, if you're actually making buffalo chicken wings, you use Frank's. That's the way it is. That's what that the original recipe has. 2 tablespoons of butter, let's say 1/4 cup of Frank's, dash of garlic powder, maybe a little over the dash, and this is the key ingredient here, Worcestershire sauce. People are like, Worcestershire sauce? Buffalo, they're gonna be like, Worcestershire sauce, fuck that guy, you don't know what he's talking about. Worcestershire sauce, couple dashes, not much, but it does bring out the flavor of the Frank's and the butter. Mix it together. See the color? It's not some crazy color, it's just wing sauce. But when you taste it, Uncle Matt, this is freaking awesome.
It's really,
it's freaking awesome. Worcestershire, just a hair. Now the wings, they gotta cook for about 12, 15 minutes. And another thing about buffalo chicken wings, okay? Crispy. You don't cook them till they're just about done. You cook them till they're done, and then you cook them. They gotta be crispy. So you just let them cook for a while. So we're making chili here on football Sunday. We'll just get right into it. I improvise my chili a lot. I know that it comes out good. I kind of sit there and I taste it until it's done. We're gonna turn on our stove here to medium high heat. And we are gonna put in some olive oil. And we are going to put in our onions. It's always what you do. It's like olive oil, onions, garlic. Now, I just recently got some, it's pepper season. Everybody's picking their peppers. I got friends, they know I cook. So I'm putting in some jalapenos here and some, these are, I think, Thai chilies here. So it's gonna be pretty friggin' hot by the time we're done here. We're gonna get those sweating a little bit. And I'm also, I use tube meats. I'm gonna go beef. Now, I know a lot of people, when they make the chili, they'll do ground beef and they'll do chunks of beef. I'm just putting ground in. And I also put hot Italian sausage in. Say hot Italian sausage, we're making chili here in Mexico. But you use these two things together, I promise you it's gonna be amazing. 1/2 pound of ground beef, 1/2 pound of hot Italian sausage, and let them go. Oh yeah, look at that. We are about ready. See that? When your wings look like that, we're ready.
Yum!
All right, here we go. Dump them in this here bowl. our sauce we made. Put some sauce in here to dress them. Now we're gonna shake them around. Smell that. Smells good. Hey Madison. Come here. You guys have seen my daughter Madison before on this show. She makes cookies with me. But this is her dinner, so yes, you are just eating them. It's hot. That's gonna be yum.
A+.
There you go. Here we are, buffalo chicken wings on football day. Blue cheese. Anything you serve with wings other than blue cheese is blasphemy. No ranch dressing. Buffalo chicken wings, blue cheese, carrot, celery. Enjoy.
No more ranch! No more ranch! No more ranch! No more ranch! No more ranch!
All right, our meat is browned, our veggies are sweated. Let's put it all together here. So now this is where it gets improvisational, just like our music. Chili powder. I'm gonna tell you it's like at least a tablespoon, maybe two. You put a lot of it in there. Cumin. Half of what you put in of chili powder is cumin. So you're talking, let's say, tablespoon and a half, 3/4 tablespoon. Oregano, Mexican would be preferred. Teaspoon. Paprika, I just put a little in. It's kind of for color and it has some flavor to it. Cinnamon. I'm gonna put a very little bit, and you don't notice that there's cinnamon in here, but you notice that there's something different about the chili that tastes really good. So I'm gonna dash some cinnamon in. Here's the other thing, baking cocoa. Same thing, just a splash, but all of a sudden you go, wow, depth of flavor in this chili is crazy. So we got some spicings in, chili beans, which for me, I mean, I use a red kidney bean that has, or a black kidney bean that has chili spicing in it. The more stuff you put in it, can't hurt it, right? I like fire roasted tomatoes, so I'm using diced fire roasted. Beer. In particular, Hoppy Hour Hero, because it's a very yummy beer. It's very full flavored. So we're gonna do 3/4 of a beer, about. That leaves me a quarter beer to drink. And my other secret ingredient that I kinda add to just about everything is chicken bouillon. Adds depth of flavor, just adds flavor. So I put that in there, and then we let it cook. And what you end up doing, you know, after 10 or 15 minutes this thing gets boiling, taste it. If you need to adjust, you adjust. Usually the adjustments are with chili powder and cumin. You don't really have to make any other adjustments to it, unless you need salt, which we're not gonna really need, I don't think. So it's really, you know what chili tastes like, you know what it wants to taste like, or what you want it to taste like. So if it's not tasting exactly up to snuff, add a little chili powder, add a little cumin, and chili. We'll be back in a few minutes to taste it. So here we are in football season. It's fall, it's getting cold, it's rainy, and so we're making food that is warming, what they call comfort food. Here, just try this. It's a little hot. That's what you need to warm your bones when it's cold out at football season. Here we are. We got some chili. It's really delicious.
It's cooking with Vinnie.
It's cooking with Vinnie.
Our favorite time, cooking with Vinnie.
That's right.
We're very lucky to have the chef Vinnie.
That's right. All right, we're gonna serve up a little of this chili, and we're gonna have Uncle Matt try it, see what he thinks. He helped me with it. It's kind of our recipe that we've been throwing back and forth to each other for quite some time. Here you go, Uncle Matt.
Thank you.
It's good though, right? Can I try?
Perfect.
How is it, Ben?
It's fucking good. It's so good. Who likes chili?
Me.
Now you gotta try this. All right. Fucking good.
What peppers did you put in
it? Jalapenos and...
Poblanos?
Not super hot. No, it's
Thai chili.
Thai chili.
I should have brought you all the peppers out of my garden.
I've got so many chilies. Somebody's got to try this. Cold weather. Football season. Bow winter tour. Truth and will outrun your every good intention.